Acne is a very common chronic skin condition that causes pimples mostly on the face, forehead, chest, shoulders, and upper back. Our skin has pores that connect to oil glands under the skin. Each pore opens to a follicle. A follicle contains a hair and an oil gland. The oil released by the gland helps remove old skin cells and keeps your skin soft. Acne occurs when your hair follicles or the pores of your skin become plugged or blocked with dead skin cells, hair, bacteria, and sebum, which is an oily substance that normally moisturizes your skin. The result of this blockage is what we see as pimples. These pimples can take several forms, which are blackheads. They are also known as open comedo, which means open pore. Blackheads develop when sebum or excess oil and dead skin cells build up inside a pore. As the buildup accumulates, it widens the opening of the pore and you see a blackhead. The black speck is often thought to be dirt by many individuals. Actually, what you are seeing is a chemical reaction with the sebum that occurs under your skin. Melanin is oxidized and turns the clogged pores a black color. They are often found on your back, shoulders, and face. Whiteheads. They are also known as closed comedo, which means closed pore. A whitehead forms when excess oil and dead skin cells build up and plug the opening of a pore. This causes a blemish that is raised and white or flesh-colored. The bumps remain closed and are the under the skin. Like blackheads, whiteheads are typically found on your back, shoulders, and face. Papules. These are small, red or pink bumps that become inflamed. When excess oil, dead skin cells, and bacteria get trapped inside a pore, the bacteria that are often present on our skin might quickly multiply in the excess oil. This causes inflammation that appears as red or pink pimple that is known as papule. Pustules. Basically, pustules are pimples containing pus. They look like whiteheads. They are red at their base and have pus at the tops. They can cause scarring if picked or scratched. Nodules. They are large, solid, painful pimples that are found deep within your skin. Cysts. They are painful and filled with pus. They are painful because they tend to go deep into the skin. They can cause scars. Fungal acne, also known as pityrosporum folliculitis. This type occurs when an excessive yeast develops in the hair follicle. They can become itchy and inflamed. What causes acne? The main cause is thought to be a rise in androgen levels. Androgen hormones, which typically become active during the teenage and young adult years, can trigger acne. In women, it gets converted into estrogen. Rising androgen levels cause the oil glands under the skin to enlarge. The enlarged gland secretes more sebum. Excessive sebum can break down cellular walls in the pores, causing bacteria to grow. Propionibacterium acnes is the name of the bacteria that live on the skin and contributes to the infection of pimples. Other factors that may trigger acne include hormonal changes that make the skin oilier. These may be related to menstrual periods, pregnancy, birth control pills, or stress. Using oily or greasy personal care products, heavy sweating and certain weather conditions, especially high humidity. Picking at acne sores can trigger breakouts. Stress, which raises cortisol levels, can exacerbate acne. Certain drugs such as steroids, testosterone, estrogen, and phenytoin. Birth control devices, such as some drug containing intrauterine device, can make acne worse. And genetics. Some of you might be wondering whether chocolate causes acne. Research does not show that chocolate, nuts, and greasy foods cause acne. Chocolate has not been directly linked to acne. However, diets high in refined sugars or dairy products may contribute to acne flares. What are the signs and symptoms of acne? The primary sign of acne is blemishes, which are easy to spot on oneself or palpable on the skin. They often appear on the face, but acne can also develop on other areas of the body, like the neck, chest, shoulders, and back. Non-inflamed acne, also called comedonal acne, doesn't cause blemishes that are red or painful. They make the skin feel rough. Non-inflamed acne include blackheads, whiteheads, milia, and microcomedones. Inflamed acne breakouts result in red, swollen pimples. Inflamed acne can be mild, with just occasional breakouts, or it can be more severe, resulting in deep blemishes. They can be swollen, ooze, crust, and scab over. Inflamed acne breakouts include papules, pustules, and in severe cases, nodules and cysts. The most severe symptoms are seen in cystic acne, which can lead to scarring, and usually they take a long time to heal. Other skin changes that can be caused by acne are crusting of skin bumps and redness around the skin eruptions. How is acne diagnosed? Your healthcare provider can diagnose acne by looking at your skin. In most situations, testing is not required. When particular acne patterns are present or if large pus-filled bumps persist, bacterial culture may be performed to rule out infection. Older adults who experience severe acne outbreaks occasionally have another underlying condition that needs to be treated medically. How is acne treated? Treatment depends on how severe and persistent the acne is. Numerous treatments and drugs have been shown to be effective. The focus is on the underlying causes of acne. Topical medications that can be applied include salicylic acid that is available as over-the-counter medication for acne. It is available as lotion. Salicylic acid dissolves dead skin cells to prevent your hair follicles from clogging. It also assists in the breakdown of blackheads and whiteheads. Benzoyl peroxide is available as an over-the-counter medication. Examples are Clearasil, Stridex, and Panoxyl. They are available as leave-on gel or wash. It works by killing bacteria, accelerating the replacement of skin, and by slowing the production of sebum. Irritation and dryness are the most common side effects. Azelaic acid strengthens cells that line the follicles, stops sebum eruptions, and reduces bacterial growth. Retinoids, which is a vitamin A derivative, break up blackheads and whiteheads and help to prevent clogged pores. Examples of this drugs are Retin-A, Tazorac, and Differin. Dapsone, known by the brand name Exone, is a topical gel, which also has antibacterial properties, and it can be used for inflamed acne. It's applied to the skin twice a day. Antibiotics such as clindamycin and erythromycin control surface bacteria that often encourage the inflammation of acne. These antibiotics are more effective when combined with benzoyl peroxide. There are other medications that can be taken orally, and they include oral contraceptives, which can help control acne in women by suppressing the overactive gland. They are commonly used as long-term acne treatments. They help to treat breakouts associated with menstrual cycles. Examples of this medications include Estrastep, Baez, Orthotricycline, and Yaz. Oral antibiotics including tetracyclines such as minocycline and doxycycline are commonly used to treat moderate to severe acne. For the most severe cases of acne, isotretinoin, which is an oral retinoid, is used. Isotretinoin shrinks the size of oil glands, which contributes to acne formation. It is a strictly controlled medication with potentially serious side effects. The patient must sign a consent document to confirm that they are aware of the hazards and enroll in the iPledge program. The most common side effect is dryness. It can result in birth defects. Evidence suggests that there are risks of depression and ulcerative colitis. Patients who take isotretinoin must avoid vitamin A supplements, as these could lead to vitamin A toxicity. Examples of this medications are Amnestine, Clarivis, and Sotret. Other medications include, for severely inflamed acne cyst, a specialist may treat it by injecting a diluted corticosteroid to prevent scarring, reduce inflammation, and speed up the healing process. Laser treatments are used to treat acne scars. What are the complications that can be caused by acne? Acne can have a profound and lasting effect on someone's life. Acne scars is one of them. Acne can leave a permanent scar that can cause depressions in the skin. This occurs when an individual lives with acne for an extended amount of time without proper treatment. Dark spots on the skin. They are flat spots that can be pink, red, purple, black, or brown. Unlike acne scars, these spots will eventually clear on their own. Clearing can take time, though. Some spots can last for a year or longer. Acne can cause lower self-esteem during the teen and early adulthood years, which can negatively affect one's life. Self-esteem issues can be avoided by treating acne rather than letting it progress. Depression. Acne frequently results in anxiety and stress, which can occasionally cause people to retreat socially. Some of these complications, like acne scars, can be overcome with laser treatment, and camouflage makeup specially designed to cover up scars is available over the counter at pharmacy. How can acne be prevented? Here are some tips for looking after skin that has acne or is prone to it. Wash your face daily with warm water and a mild facial cleanser. Avoid popping pimples, as this makes scarring likelier. Choose non-comedogenic makeup for sensitive skin and avoid oil-based products. Remove makeup before sleeping. If acne is on the back, shoulders, or chest, try wearing loose clothing to let the skin breathe. Avoid tight garments, such as headbands, caps, and scarves, or wash them regularly if used. Use an electric shaver or sharp safety razors when shaving. Soften the skin and beard with warm soapy water before applying shaving cream. Avoid excessive sun exposure, as it can cause the skin to produce more sebum. Several acne medications increase the risk of sunburn. Avoid anxiety and stress, as it can increase production of cortisol and adrenaline, which exacerbate acne. And refrain from touching the face. And that's all for this video about acne. Thank you for watching, and if this video has been helpful, please give us a like, share it, and subscribe to our channel. Until next time.